स्टूडेंट्स, होप यू ऑल आर डूइंग ग्रेट। वी हैव डिस्कस्ड आवर फर्स्ट चैप्टर क्रॉप प्रोडक्शन एंड मैनेजमेंट थ्रू वीडियो लेक्चर्स एंड नोट्स। सो लेट्स हैव अ क्विक रिवीजन ऑफ दिस चैप्टर। व्हाट द टर्म्स दैट वी हैव लर्नड इन दिस चैप्टर। फर्स्ट, क्रॉप्स। सेकेंड, डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ क्रॉप्स, ग्रॉन in different season, that is kharif, and second is rabi crops. Next, what were the steps that we follow, that has to be followed for managing our crops? First is preparation of soil. Second, adding manure and fertilizers. Third is protection from weeds. Fourth, sowing. Fifth, irrigation. Sixth, harvesting. Sixth, storage. These are the terms that we have studied in this chapter. And one thing that I would like to introduce here about storage. A new method of grain storage involves the use of nitrogen gas. It is circulated through grain piles in silos. It replaces air and hence oxygen in silos. This kills all the pests and microorganisms. This method is easy to implement and grain can be stored for much longer period. So this is a new method of grain that we involves the use of nitrogen gas. Hello students, as we have finished our first chapter of grade 8, crop production and management, let's discuss bookwork of this chapter. First, multiple choice questions. Crops grown in rainy season are called rabi crop, season crop, monsoon crop, kharif crop. The answer is kharif crop. Rabi crops are grown in summer, winter, spring and rainy. So what should be the answer? Winter. Which of the following condition is not essential to grow maize? High temperature, humidity, low temperature, rainfall is not essential. So the answer is low temperature. Question can be changed in another form. What are the essential conditions that are required to grow maize? So the answer will be high temperature, humidity and rainfall. So question can be changed in any form. So you have to read it carefully. Harvesting can be done by plowing, threshing, manuring, irrigation. So the answer is threshing. Following is true for describing fertilizers used in large quantity, organic in nature, do not cause pollution, produced in factories. So the answer is produced in factories. Now true, false. Tilling brings nutrient rich soil to the top. Yes, it's true. Threshing is done after harvesting. It's true. What is harvesting? It's cutting the matured crop from the fields. Now, fertilizers provide humus to soil. Is it correct? No. Manures. It's false. The correct is manures. provide humus to soil. Manure has less amount of plant nutrient. Yes, it's true. Freshly harvested grains must be dried before storing. It's true. Why it should be dried? So that it can be free from rats and insects. Now, fill-ups. The first step before growing crop is preparation of soil. Process of loosening of soil is called ploughing and tilling. Next, undesirable plants that grow along with the crop are called weeds. Dash is the process of separating grains or seeds from chaff, that is threshing. And we have did experiment on threshing related to related practical on threshing that we have done in previous class also. Growing different crops alternatively on the same land is technically called crop rotation. Now match the column. First, ploughing. How can you relate it? It's related with hoe. Hoe is an agricultural implement that is used to remove the weeds. So this is one. Now sowing. Sowing is related to, yes, seed drill. Seed drill is one of the method of sowing. Next, irrigation. Irrigation, think over it. Sprinkler, yes, it is one of the modern methods of irrigation. Harvesting, think, got it? Okay. Harvesting relates to this harvester or sickle. Moving on, very short answer type questions. Give two examples of kharif crops, paddy and maize. I have given these two. You can give any other like soya bean or maize. Give two examples of rabi crops, wheat and pea. You can write gram also. Name the chemical sprayed in the field to kill the weed. What is the name of that chemical? That is this weedicide? Is it weedicide? Yes, this is weedicide like 2,4-D. Why are weeds not good for the crops? Wheat are not good for the crops because they affect the quality of the crops. They are unwanted plants, so we need to remove them. Name the tool used with a tractor for sowing seeds in a field. So name the tool, that is seed drill. Seed drill is the tool that is used with a tractor for sowing seeds in a field. Next question. Name methods of irrigation that conserve water. Traditional and modern methods are the methods of irrigation that conserve water. Now, name different methods of harvesting. First is manual harvesting. Second is mechanical harvesting. So these are two methods that are used in harvesting. And mechanical harvesting is done by machines. Name the branch of science that deals with the management and care of animals, that is animal husbandry. Now moving on, short question answer. First is state three methods by which growth of weeds is controlled. So here is answer. Ways to control weeds, I have shown it through this circles like flowchart type. It's not exactly a flow chart, but it's a kind of a figure, or it's a kind of a circle that I have shown it to you through. so that it can be easy for you in learning. Ways to remove, ways to control weeds, or question, if question is asked to you, how weeds can be removed, the same answer will be there. First, by tilling and plowing. Second, by using weedicides. Third, manually removing seeds. And how weeds are removing manually, that is by khurpi. Now, moving on, question number 2. Give 3 advantages of adding manure to crops. This is on page 4. So, here is the answer. Short answer to advantages of manures. They add nutrients to the soil and increases its fertility. They add organic matter to the soil, which improves the texture of soil. They increase the water holding capacity of soil. Now, question number 3. Which activity of the farmer can promote growth of earthworms in field? Can you tell me the name of the activity? Yes, this is plowing. Plowing is an activity of the farmer can promote growth of earthworms in field. Now, what are the advantages of using the seed drill versus manual sowing? It's on page number 4. Now, the question is advantages of using seed drills over manual method. So, what are the advantages basically of using method or using this method, that is seed drill? The seeds are sown uniformly at proper distance and depth. Second, जो seeds हैं वो uniformly मतलब एक जैसी proper distance पे और एक जैसी गहराई में sow की जाती है, grow करवाई जाती है. Next, it prevents damage caused by the birds as seeds are always sown below the soil. So, इसमें जो seeds हैं वो बहुत ज़्यादा damage नहीं होती. The reason is हमने अभी previous एडवांटेज में देखा है कि वो यूनिफॉर्मली ग्रोन होती है. एंड सेकंड इज कि प्रॉपर डिस्टेंस और डेप्थ में, गहराई में सो की करवाई जाती है. सो दिस इज द रीजन कि जो हमारी जो सीड ड्रिल के थ्रू जो हमारी सीड्स हैं वो ज्यादा डैमेज नहीं होती, बिकॉज वो डेप्थ में होती हैं और बर्ड्स उनको इजिली नहीं खा पाते. एंड इट सेव्स टाइम एंड लेबर बिकॉज दिस इज अ मेथड यूज्ड बाय मशीन. So definitely it saves our time. And second, now traditional method. यहाँ पे हमने कहा कि uniformly seeds sow करवाई जाती हैं, uniformly एक जैसी. So here what we are trying to say कि यहाँ पर जो seeds हैं वो randomly soil में distribute की जाती है. I shouldn't say it's distribute क्योंकि randomly जब हम बोलते हैं कि randomly वो soil में डाल दी जाती है. नेक्स्ट, सम सीड्स आर नॉट सोन यूनिफॉर्मली. सीड्स जो है वो यूनिफॉर्मली सोन नहीं करवाई जाती, दैट्स वाई सीड्स दैट रिमेन ऑन द सर्फेस आर ईटन बाय द बर्ड्स. नेक्स्ट, इट इज टाइम कंज्यूमिंग बिकॉज दिस इज मैनुअल मेथड. नाउ मूविंग ऑन, नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, व्हाट आर द एडवांटेजेस ऑफ ड्रिप इरिगेशन. सो हियर इज द आंसर. Advantages of drip irrigation. Weed growth is lessened. जो हमारे unwanted undesirable plants grow जाते हैं, that is lessened. Field leveling is not necessary. Labor cost is less than other irrigation method. Thank you so much.